I can drive 55!
Because it's more efficient and safer, right? Hey there, Grandma Drivers. This is Big Rig Science Pappy Trace for D-News. What's your 20? Old cars and highways often have a speed limit of 55 because of efficiency. It started in 1973 when the US was under an oil embargo. To conserve resources, Congress tied the state speed limits to federal highway funding, basically forcing states to adhere to 55 or else they'd lose millions in highway money. They picked 55 because the Argonne National Laboratory, they do a lot of traffic research, found that that was the speed most cars would get the best miles per gallon. Once the embargo ended, Congress was reluctant to lift the limit until 1995. Afterward, states went on a tizzy trying to pick new speed limits. Most chose 70, but some chose 65 or 80. Yes, Texas, I know you got a little bit of 85 up in there, you get a cookie, whatever. But how did they decide on those numbers? Well, firstly, exceeding the speed limit or driving too fast for the conditions is the primary cause of auto crashes globally, which is why we have speed limits in the first place. But it's important to know too fast for conditions, that's a big deal. Because speed limits are determined by data, but the data is from three main things: nature, engineering, and humans. Obviously, this is all a simplification, because it's complicated stuff. But for example, when highway and traffic researchers decide a speed limit, they take into account the weather, visibility, terrain, the location of the road, and so on. That's the nature. They also take into account the purpose of the road, crash risks, traffic and truck flow monitors, those little rubber tubes you sometimes run over on the road, what the road is made of, the amount of shoulder next to the road, maintenance schedules. That's the engineering. And of course, how humans actually use the road, which we'll come back to in a second. They then take that data and they use different computer and cost-based models to specifically pick the speed for that stretch of road. The human component has a lot to do with safety, but also our ability to actually drive on the road at that speed. The operating speed model is often used. It sort of crowdsources the speed limit using something called the 85th percentile rule. Basically, researchers observe the average speed people on a road naturally want to use, and they lob off the speediest 15%. Research has shown that the 85th percentile is the speed most people would be comfortable driving, which is super important because be it 55 or 85, the researchers and lawmakers want a speed limit that is, quote, accepted as reasonable by a majority of road users. So nature, engineering, and humans together factor in to how we pick speed limits. And all of that kind of makes sense. You know, faster speeds tend towards stretches of road in like Montana or Texas or Australia, where roads are more open, it's sparsely populated, the roads are straighter. While denser, high traffic urban areas with more weather considerations, those tend towards slower speeds, duh, right? Speed limits are ultimately human things, but they're based on physics plus biology. Faster speeds mean less time for our animal brains to react when something goes wrong. According to the European Road Safety Observatory, for every 1 km/h increase in speed, there's a 3% increase in crashes. It's an old saying that it's not the crash that kills you, but the sudden stop at the end. The faster you're going, the data says, the more kinetic energy is in the vehicle, and the worse the crash is gonna be. This is why some regions likely have lower speed limits for their conditions, roads, and drivers. Once the speeds are picked, researchers are constantly going back and adding new data and testing the road at various speeds and in various conditions. Look, everyone who drives a car wants to get where they're going as efficiently, quickly, and safely as possible, even traffic researchers. But every road and every type of road is different. The reason that that speed limit is on that road is a mix of lots of data and lots of human effort. It also takes a lot of effort to keep your car clean. Techron by Chevron's patented Precision Clean technology targets and removes deposits left by lower tier gasolines. It bonds with and breaks apart carbon deposits more effectively than other additive technologies. Techron gets into the deepest parts of the engine where the most destructive deposits build up and sweeps them away. But what about self-driving cars? Should they have speed limits too? Are they even safer? Sources say the cars have been rear-ended mostly, but they've also been sideswiped and hit by a car that ran a red light or a stop sign. Since the crash specifics are secret, we can't be entirely certain, but Google says that the car was never at fault. What do you think? Should speed limits be higher, lower? Are you just waiting for the self-driving revolution? Let me know down in the comments. Make sure you subscribe so you get all of the episodes of D-News that we make, and that's a lot of them. And thanks for watching.